Hello, this video will introduce Ozone, the J-Link debugger, and demonstrate how to get started with your first Ozone project. Ozone is a full-featured graphical debugger perfect for working on any ARM-based embedded application. With Ozone, it is possible to debug any embedded application on C source and assembly level. Ozone can load applications built by any ARM toolchain and even debug targets resident application without any source. Ozone is tightly coupled with Segger's set of J-Link debug probes to ensure optimal performance and user experience. In conjunction with J-Link technology, you get one of the fastest stepping debuggers for embedded systems in the market. The Ozone download is available from this page. Mac, Linux, and PC platforms are supported. Once installed, you should see a folder similar to this one. Double-click to launch Ozone. This is where you can select a previously saved project file. These have a .jdebug extension. Ozone project files are written in a simplified C style. A project file can include some predefined functions which are called on specific events, on loading the project, on debug start, before and after connection, before and after download, and before and after target reset. The file can be used for automation of the debug session. When creating a new project with the project wizard, all available functions will be added to the project file, providing users a good starting point for their own configurations. Let's start with the project wizard. I'll be using my trusted Empire board with M4 target in this demo. Empire has a NXP K66 device. Let's select that. Yes, I need the SVD file for easier peripheral register views. Here it is. Okay, select the ELF file to debug. Ozone supports many other data and program ELF compatible files. It supports Motorola, S-Record, Intel Hex, and also binary formats. Note that if the associated project is recompiled, Ozone will automatically detect this and prompts the user to load the new code and debug information. Here we are, click on the green icon and a pop-up appears detailing the license terms. Carefully read through, and if you agree, click yes. The tool will now download the code and launch the debug session. Okay, now we have our debug session established with the latest code. Let's see what the tool can offer. Single stepping, step over, step into are supported here. Click the blue arrow or F5 to start the code execution. Click F6 or here halts the code. That's where we'll stop for now. Our next video will go into some of the differentiating features of Ozone and walk through some of the capabilities it offers. Let's save this configuration for the next session. There. Thanks for watching.